A Baltimore City teen says he was knocked off of his dirt bike by a police officer and then tased. And now he and his mother are speaking out. 11 News reporter Karen Campbell joins us from the 11 Newsroom with more on this. Karen.
Deborah, 16-year-old Tyquan Ford, whose friends call him Pug, says the incident left him with bruises and now he has to walk with crutches. Under current law, it is illegal to ride dirt bikes on the streets and police aren't allowed to chase offenders. Now, that's why Ford and his mom helped to create a documentary called 12 O'Clock Boys to shed light on the group of riders and how it's helping some stay out of trouble.
Body hurt. Sore.
Meet 16-year-old Pug Ford.
Like, when that first happened, my adrenaline was rushing, so I ain't feel nothing.
The Baltimore City teen and some friends were out riding their dirt bike Saturday night. That is illegal in Baltimore City and something the state's attorney and city police believe is a serious public safety threat. So serious that police officers do not routinely give chase. But Pug says that wasn't the case Saturday night when he says a police officer began chasing him.
And when I was turning, but the turn on Lafayette, it was a police car just sitting in. It came out real fast and just bumped me from the front. I flew off the bike. My shoe came off. That's when I jumped out. I was ready to grab the bike, but he jumped out, so I ran.
Then he says he was tased.
They seen red dots on the walls, and that's when I just felt a shock, and that's when I just dropped.
I ain't see the taser. I just heard him. I heard it like zern. You know how you hear a taser like zern real loud? That's all I heard, and then I heard him saying, ah, ah.
The police is not right.
Coco Brown is Pug's mother. She took photos of his wounds.
Then I seen a burn mark on his side, like a hip, like a hook, and I knew that he was tased. I thought the law was no chasing, but they still chasing. They could have killed my son out there.
Brown says her son didn't do anything wrong, and he wasn't charged with a crime. She says she just wants her son to continue doing something he loves.
They not out here killing nobody. They not out here hurting nobody.
We reached out to Baltimore City Police earlier today. While not able to talk about the reason policy was not followed in this case, a spokesman did confirm there was an incident resulting in injury, and the department is investigating all of the events of Saturday night. Now, Brown says the main reason for making the documentary 12 O'Clock Boys was to send a message to the public and to the police, and that finding a park or another area where her son and other dirt bike riders can safely ride needs to be a priority. In the newsroom, Karen Campbell, WBAL-TV 11 News.